Hi YouTube watchers and subscribers, this is Waves from SlideNerd over here. In this video, I'm going to talk about how you can use custom fonts inside your app. Now by default, Android supports only a few fonts. If you want to use something like Verdana or Lucida console, then you'll have to load a custom font and use it. So let's actually see how to do that. There are certain things that you guys need to keep in mind before loading custom fonts. One, the format for the font should be either TTF or OTF. 2. The fonts will also be downloaded along with your app if you're including it as part of your assets, and that means the size of your app increases. So make sure that you keep a fonts with low size inside your app. And then your custom fonts are accessed in code only at the time of making this vid. Perhaps in the future that changes. And next, you're gonna use this class called Typeface, which has certain create methods, and this is the way you're gonna load your custom font inside your app. And I'm gonna show you exactly what this class is and what these methods do. Don't worry about that too much right now. And then if the font is invalid, Android will you don't have to worry about what Android will do, whether your app will crash or something. Don't worry, because Android uses the defaults. And one more thing, take care of copyright issues. Now it may be happening that you use a font which is copy protected, and you may run into trouble because of that. There is this class called Typeface in Android that represents fonts, and it represents both the system inbuilt fonts and the fonts that you create. So let's actually see what kind of method it has. You have this method typeface.create that allows you to load the font by giving it a certain family name and a style, which can be bold, italic, or bold and italic combined. And then you have this method typeface.create from asset, where you can specify that the font should be inside the assets folder inside your app, and you can load it from there using the asset manager. Now don't worry too much about how to use this. I will show you how to use this in Android Studio. And third is that your Android font, which is your custom font file, is inside your SD card, and you want to load it from there. Here you can simply specify the file name or the path name of your directory inside which your custom font is there, and you can simply load it. So let's actually go ahead and see what are the steps to load a custom font inside your app. First of all, select the view inside code where you want to use custom font. Now it may be possible that you have a text view inside which you want to load custom font, and it is there inside XML. You need to bring that text view inside Java code. Second, use the typeface object by using the typeface.create methods that contain the custom font. Now remember, either the custom font is actually a font family that is existent on your device, or it is a custom font file inside your assets folder, or it is inside your SD card. You want to use this typeface object to create or link to that custom font file that you have loaded in your device. And then set the view to use the typeface object. Now we are going to actually see this in Android Studio in action about how to load a custom font. Alright, so here I'm using Android Studio. I'm going to make the custom font project in this. You can see the font is project is already created. You have by your source folder, Java, inside which you have your main activity, which is your Java code for the app. And then you have your RES layout, inside which you have your appearance defined in this XML file. Alright, so first step is to actually decide which view you want to use and what you want to do with it. So here, let me modify this text hello world to something else. Alright, so now you can see the text which says hello from SlideNerd. This is the text view on which I'm going to use a custom font. For that, the first step I need to do is to bring this text view inside my Java code, because at the time of making this vid, custom fonts don't work in XML. You'll have to use Java code to modify the font style. Alright, so for that I'm gonna give an ID here first. I'm gonna say Android ID @ID slash, I'm gonna call it my text. As you guys can see, things don't look properly formatted. You can simply arrange that by pressing Ctrl Alt L in your Android Studio. So click run, and there you go, everything is done. So let's go to the main activity here. Let me create the text view first, because I'm going to bring the object from XML into Java. I'm going to say text view. At this point, you probably get an error saying this class is not recognized or cannot resolve the symbol. You press Alt Enter, import the class, and there you're done. So now let's initialize this by saying t equals to, I'm going to use this method called find view by ID that links XML to Java code. I'm going to say r.id.myText. And then again, what I have done here is nothing great. You guys have seen this too many times. Find view by ID is gonna link this ID my text and convert that into a Java object which will be assigned to T. Alright. So again, there is an error saying incompatible types. Press Alt Enter. Cast to Android. Blah blah blah. Let's do that, and they are done. So I've simply typecasted this object to type text view. Alright. Second step is to bring your custom font file, which is your TTF or OTF file, inside your app. So for that, there are two ways. You can either bring it inside the assets folder, or you can bring it on your SD card. So I'm gonna bring it inside my assets folder over here. First, let me create the folder by going to main. I'm gonna say new directory. I'll call this assets. Click OK. Inside this, I need to create a folder called fonts, where that thing will be placed. For that, I'm gonna say new again and select package. I'll call it fonts. Click OK. And there you go, assets and fonts. So first, let me bring the TTF file inside this. Alright, so inside the fonts, I'm gonna say right click and paste. And there you go, 03.ttf is the custom font that I would like to use. Now this contains all the definitions for the different characters. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have to create a Java object out of these definitions. Alright, for that, I'll use a typeface class. I'm gonna say typeface. Now this is the class that allows you to represent fonts or create them from scratch. So I'm gonna say typeface.create from asset. Now this is the method I'll use to load this file from assets in the form of a Java object. I'm gonna say typeface.create from asset. It's gonna ask me two parameters. One is the asset manager, the other is the exact path inside which this file 03.ttf is located. Now what is this asset manager? It is nothing but an Android object that manages the contents inside this assets folder. Now how can I get a reference to that? Very simple, I'll say get assets. As you guys can see, get assets is a method that actually gives you the asset manager. So I'm gonna say get assets over here, comma, the path. The path is gonna be fonts slash 03.ttf. So I bet that is perfectly named at this point. So this typeface.create from blah 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 is actually gonna give me a typeface object. I'm gonna say typeface my custom font. So that at this point I've created a reference saying typeface my custom font. Now we are almost done. We need to do only one more thing. Find the text view T. Use the set typeface method to set a custom font on the text view. So here I'm gonna simply pass a reference to the my custom font which I created above, and we are done. So let's actually save this. I run it at the top. Alright, so at this point my emulator is up, and there you go. Bam, we are done. Take a look. There's the hello from SlideNote text using our custom font defined in 03.ttf. So I hope you guys have understood something out of this vid. If you like what you saw, please subscribe to my channel. Let me know your thoughts. Stay tuned. I'll be making a lot of vids. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you guys later. Have a nice day.